This is a celebration of life. This is a celebration of success. We shouldn't be sad. We should be happy that this man enjoyed his life and did it his way.
The real purpose of what I do was to try to have the city totally involved and identified with it. And I wanted that when you think L.A., oh, wait, that's where the Lakers play. Lakers, Lakers, that's what I wanted.
There is an empty seat tonight at Staples Center, but the spirit of Dr. Jerry Buss will fill the arena as long as the Lakers take the court. Good evening, I'm Micah Oman. Welcome to a very special show. Tonight we're remembering the life of a man who helped shape the city of Los Angeles, Dr. Jerry Buss.
And I'm Cher Calvin. The beloved owner of the Los Angeles Lakers, Dr. Buss, lost his battle with cancer on Monday, but he leaves behind a legacy that will never be forgotten. He guided the Lakers to 10 world championships, along the way building the team into a global brand and a source of intense city pride. We begin our celebration in the most fitting place, a sold-out Staples Center. Tonight, Dr. Buss's Lakers are in action, and KTLA's Doug Kolk joins us live with more reaction on his passing. Doug?
Well, good evening, Micah and Cher. Fans just now starting to pour out. And even at this hour, the way it currently stands, on both sides of the Staples Center, there are memorial walls which honor Dr. Buss that people can go up to and sign. They have become so popular that they're now on their eighth wall.
Right here. It says, rest in peace, Jerry.
Rest in heaven, Mr. Buss.
They come from all over.
I'm from Atlanta, Georgia.
I'm from Utah.
To pay their respect to a sports legend.
That was the first thing on my agenda. I wanted to sign the board and I wanted to take a picture, not just for myself, but for all my Lakers fans back home.
Tonight marks the first game since the heartfelt memorial for past Lakers owner Dr. Jerry Buss.
He was the owner. He was like Mr. Lakers.
And for the fourth straight day since his passing.
I wrote Dr. Buss, thanks for the championships.
Fans like Josh Turryberry.
Josh Turryberry, rest in peace.
Have been signing this memorial wall outside Staples Center.
It just shows the relentlessness of people that actually care about a man that they didn't know personally. I mean, just the man that they've known through their sports and Lakers.
Dr. Buss died Monday from cancer at the age of 80. He was laid to rest this morning in a private burial at Forest Lawn Memorial Park. He leaves behind 6 children, 10 championships, and an entire fan base.
It's not just one team that's going to miss him. He changed the game itself and the league itself.
Jerry, you were a fantastic owner. We will always miss you.
And you just saw those memorial walls. Each wall is property of the Lakers. And when I spoke to representatives of the organization, they tell me they don't yet have plans where they're going to permanently display those walls. But they do tell me they may still be up after tonight's game, even maybe for the Kings game tomorrow. We'll send it back to you guys in Hollywood.
Doug Kolk for us at Staples Center tonight. Doug, thank you. A memorial service for Dr. Buss was held yesterday afternoon at the Nokia Live Theater. Former and current Lakers, family members, and close friends paid a touching tribute to Dr. Buss. KTLA's Glenn Walker takes us inside the ceremony.
You got a friend in me.
The friends of Dr. Jerry Buss.
Somehow you left without me, but I'm sure I'll catch the next flight out.
One of his 6 children.
Not everything went right, but because he was always thinking ahead, everything became right.
Those he did business with.
Staples Center and LA Live would not be here today without Dr. Buss.
Indeed, he did consider it a family business in which all of his children would be schooled and included.
We are all richer for have known him. As I say, he's left a gigantic shadow for all sports.
He said he was hoping to win one more championship. I told him I thought he had a talented enough team to win more than one, and I was going to accomplish that. We were able to do that.
Jerry Buss was us as much as we were Jerry. Showtime was the in-between. The elixir of our lives that made us all smile together.
And then there were the players, Lakers legends and legends in the making. Leave it to Shaq to deliver the humor.
I wanted one extension, he gave it to me. I wanted a second extension, he gave it to me. I wanted a third extension, he traded me.
Jerry embraced life with the same enthusiasm and energy that Magic embraced me when we beat the Clippers in his first NBA game.
You know what I'm talking about, right?
Look at the greatness of one man's vision. Look at all the players that are here, the coaches that are here. We all have one thing in common, is that we all believed in Dr. Jerry Buss.
Man, so what he would do was put me in business situations, and I didn't know he was doing that, to get me ready for life after basketball. Come on, stand on up, because he touched everybody's life in this room. Stand on up.
Earlier today at a small private service, Jerry Buss was laid to rest. Now, the Lakers have not said whether or not Dr. Buss will be immortalized with a statue outside of Staples Center, but many agree that no man is more deserving. In the newsroom, I'm Glenn Walker. Now back to you.
And you can see from the memorial service that Dr. Jerry Buss left a very personal mark on many of the people he knew. Professionally, his legacy may be even greater. Darren Horton now joins us with more on the owner that many consider to be the greatest in sports history.
Yes, Sharon, in a city known for its stars, he was among the biggest, admired, beloved, revered. Through his vision and leadership, the Lakers brand became as identifiable with Los Angeles as the Hollywood sign. All this from a life that reads like a screenplay.
The Lakers repeat back-to-back titles.
During his mercurial 35-year run as owner of the Lakers, this was Jerry Buss's final crowning achievement, a win over the arch-rival Boston Celtics in the 2010 NBA Finals.
The Lakers win their 16th title, and this has to be one of the sweeter ones.
Incredibly, it was the Lakers' 10th title in Los Angeles while Dr. Buss owned the team.
Hey, look at this! What?
But the story of Gerald Hatton Buss began much less auspiciously in a small office in Santa Monica in the mid-1970s. That's where Dr. Jerry Buss, a former math and science nerd with a PhD in physical chemistry from USC, had taken a small chunk of money he'd made investing in real estate, buying a world team tennis franchise known as the LA Strings.
A great match. Chris Evert wins it 7-6.
But even as he was signing stars like Chris Evert and Ilie Anastasi to play for his little boutique tennis team, the man from Utah and later Wyoming was dreaming of something much, much bigger. In the late 1970s, Buss told the LA Times he had no doubt he would one day own the Lakers. And in 1979, he did. With a gambler's luck and impeccable business foresight, Buss bought the Lakers, the Kings, the Forum, and a ranch in Bakersfield from Jack Kent Cooke in May of 1979 for a then-record price of $67.5 million. And when the Lakers drafted a kid out of Michigan State named Irvin Magic Johnson, a Laker dynasty was about to take flight.
Three, intercepted by Magic, and here he comes from behind the back.
He's a great man. He made everybody feel welcome around him. He's a very unassuming man. If you just met him just sitting at a bar, he'd sit there and have a beer with you. You wouldn't even know what he did for a living.
Along with all his other accomplishments, Jerry Buss also is responsible for breathing life back into the LA boxing scene in the 80s and 90s with his Forum Boxing Company, a huge fan of the sport. Buss kept the company going until 1999, despite millions of dollars in losses. Cher, Micah, back to you.
Darren, thanks. We have much more ahead as we remember the life of Dr. Jerry Buss.
We're going to hear more from the Lakers of the past and present to new and best. Rebecca Hall joins us with her one-on-one interviews with Magic Johnson, Jerry West, and others.
And the man who wrote the book on the Buss family, Steve Springer, joins us live here in studio to share 25 years of Laker memories.
To me, the mark of a great man is not the towering monuments he's built during his life, but the tender memories he's left in those who remain after his life. The fact that so many of us have come together to celebrate those tender memories of Jerry Buss is a testament to his greatness.